boys and girls of every age, wouldn't you like to see something strange?
Come with us and you will see. This our town of Halloween.
This is Halloween. This is Halloween.
Pumpkins scream in the dead of night.
This is Halloween.
It is Tuesday, October 27th, 2020, and it is a D-Day. I'm Abby Files.
And I'm Kevin Friend. Good morning, everyone.
School pictures for sophomores and juniors have arrived. If you ordered a picture package, you can pick them up this week, today, Thursday, and Friday during all three lunches in Cafeteria 1 at the Student Center located in the back corner of the cafeteria.
Spirit Month is underway, and this week is College and Military Shirt Week. The other Spirit Weeks are as follows. Next week is Red, White, and Blue Week, then Pajama Week, and finally we'll end things off with the CNS Colors Week. Seniors wear blue, juniors wear green, and sophomores wear white.
Order your yearbook for only $60 by cash or check if you pay in school. Checks should be made out to CNS Yearbook. Nameplates are available for an additional $6. Orders are being taken every day before school, only in room 318. Credit cards can be used online at balfour.com. After December, the price goes up, so order today.
And now, here's CNS Sports with Nolan.
This past weekend, both the boys and girls cross-country teams swept Liverpool with what seemed like a trouble-free race for most. The CNS boys cross country team has many experienced runners. The North Stars runners took 3rd through 5th place, with RJ Davis finishing just 4.3 seconds behind the 1st place runner. Well done, RJ. As for the girls cross country team, former athlete of the week Kate Putman took home 1st place. She left everyone in the dust as the next closest runner finished nearly a minute after her. Marissa Navarro placed 3rd with a time of 19:49. The CNS girls varsity soccer team took care of Whitesboro on Saturday, defeating them 4-0. Madeline Jackson scored two goals, with Juliana Marullo and Brianna Dorrance each netted one. Goalie Avery Burns and Ava Field combined for 3 saves in the shutout. They improved their record to 4-2-1 on the season. Great job, girls. Boys varsity soccer hosted ESM at Michael J. Bragman Stadium last night. Great game to both teams going back and forth, both goalies making some great saves. Wyatt Duplell, starting sophomore goalie, made 10 saves. The game went into overtime, and with 3 minutes left, ESM was awarded a free kick, and they scored to remain undefeated. The boys did get a win against Whitesboro 1-0 at Gillette Road Stadium last Thursday. Great goal scored by Zane Throckmorton, crossed in by William Darko Jr., leading the boys to a victory on their senior night. All in all, a great week for the boys' soccer team. The girls' tennis team is playing at 4:30 up against Fayetteville Manlius after a tough loss to Liverpool. Speaking of Liverpool, we have our girls' soccer team playing at 7 o'clock tonight. Good luck, girls.
Thanks, Nolan. Today for lunch, there will be French toast with sausage, hash browns, fruit juice, and fresh fruit.
And we'll be back right after this.
I was working in the lab late one night when my eyes beheld an eerie sight, for my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
He did the mash. He
did the... And that's all for today from the CNS Morning Show. I'm Kevin.
And I'm Abby Files. Have a great day.